Hi, today I'm doing a video for multiplication division with sine numbers. My name is Carly McAvoy. When you're multiplying and dividing with sine number, there's two rules to remember. There's a lot of different ways to say this. I'm saying this a way that makes sense to me. And that is, if you multiply or divide with an even number of negative signs, your answer will be positive. An even number of negative signs gives you a positive answer. So let's look at some examples of that. Negative 3 times negative 5. You see how there's two negative signs? That's even number. 2 is even. Since there's an even number, then we get a positive answer, 15. If we're dividing with 2, that's even again. Two negatives is an even number. So 20 divided by 4 gives you positive 5. Here I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 terms. But count the number of negatives. That's what I'm saying, the number of negative signs. You have 1, 2, 3, 4 negative signs. Since you have 4 negative signs, that's an even number that you're going to give you positive 12. Because essentially what happens is when you have 2 negative signs, they sort of cancel each other out. And then 2 more cancel each other out. And there's no negative signs left over. If I had an odd number, I'd have a different situation. And now here for the last one, again, these two negatives cancel each other out. Negative 50 and negative 2 would be positive 25. That's the first rule. If you have an even number, you get a positive answer. So the second rule, may be able to guess that then. If you multiply or divide with an odd number of negative signs, your answer will be negative. So even is positive and odd is negative. Those are the things that are important to remember about those two rules. So let's look at the examples with an odd number. An odd number could be 1, which is what happens a lot. You have a positive and a negative. You have 1 negative sign. See how these two canceled each other out? There's no negative sign to cancel that out, so I get negative 28. Notice the 7 times 4 part stays the same. Here, if I have a fraction, I have 1 negative. Remember, a negative on the bottom could just go out front. That means the same thing. But it can't just go in the top. It could go in the top or the bottom or front or whatever. It could do that. So 3 over 12 is reduced to 1/4, but because I have 1 negative sign, I overall have a negative answer. That's an odd number of negatives. Here, same thing. You see how these two could maybe cancel each other out? But there's an odd man out. There's 1 negative that can't be canceled. That's why our sign is going to be negative for that, because we have an odd number of negatives. So 1 times 2 times 3 is 6, but it's a negative 6 because of that odd number of negatives. And over here, finally, same thing. If I have a negative divided by a positive, that's 1. So that's going to give me a negative 3 overall. So try these. Again, you know what you should be doing is trying these, then coming back, seeing how you did, and then we can check them together. But I'm going to go ahead and work them now, and you can pause if that makes sense to you. So for the first one, we're multiplying. We have an odd number. There's nothing to cancel that out. So you should have gotten negative 70. I've made these numbers to where you could do these in your head. You're not trying to use the calculator here. You're trying to get the rules down, and we're just using easy numbers so that you don't have to spend time putting that into the calculator. For the second one, anything divided by itself is always 1. It's always positive 1. Here we can see we have 2 negatives, which make a positive, and 10 over 10 is 1. That'd be a positive number. The next one, I have 2 negatives. That's an even number, so I should have positive 20. For the next one, I have 2 negatives. Okay, you might say, what do I do? Divide that and get, decimal? No, don't do that. If it's a fraction, in lowest terms, just leave it as a fraction. But those 2 negatives should go. So I need to say, in lowest terms, this is actually 7/8, because the 2 negatives cancel each other out. Whenever you have a fraction, you want to cancel the 2 negatives like that. And the last one, 18 divided times negative 2, you got 1. That's an odd number. So that's going to be negative 36. Over here, I combine division and multiplication. You would do both parts separately. But what would you have on the top? Well, negative 4, there's nothing to do there. On the bottom, negative 2 times negative 1, you see how that's 2 negatives? We're going to multiply and make that positive. Remember, the rules for addition and subtraction are different. These rules apply to multiply and divide only. And finally, we're going to say we have a negative divided by a positive, so we have one negative, and that's going to be negative 2. Here I have four terms, but I have an odd man out. I have three different negatives, so these two would cancel each other out, but I'd be left with that. 3 times 5 is 15, times 2 is 30, and it's going to be negative 30 because I have an extra odd number of negatives. Over here, I can see I have 1, 2, 3, 4 negatives. I know right away I'm going to have a positive number. I know because there's no addition or subtraction here, just the rules for multiply and divide. On the top, I get a negative times a negative, which is a positive. 20 times 1 is 20. And on the bottom, I get negative 4 times negative 5, which is also positive 20. And so the answer there would just be 1. Okay, the thing about multiplying and dividing, that they're usually easier for people than adding and subtracting, but I want you to beware of something that people make mistakes with quite a bit, and that is these two things, negative 2 to the 4th power and the quantity negative 2 to the 4th power have two different signs when you finish and work that out. It has to do with the base of the expression. So let's look at that for a second. If you have negative 2 to the 4th power, the base is 2. The only thing that's going to the 4th power here is 2. In other words, it looks like this, negative 2 times 2 times 2 times 2. That's what that expression actually says. That negative has nothing to do with the power. The base is what is repeated, and the base here is 2, so when I multiply that out, I get negative 16, because I only had one negative out in the front, okay? I could think of this expression as negative 1 times 2 to the 4th power. Really, that's what's happening, right? That negative out front is not part of that at all. It just makes it negative overall. On the other hand, if I have negative 2 to the 4th power, the base is negative 2, right? The entire thing is in parentheses. That means that whole thing is being repeated. That is negative 2 times negative 2 times negative 2 times negative 2. And now if we think back to those rules that we saw at the top, we have an even number of negatives. And so we have a positive number. And essentially what's happening, you can see, these two negatives cancel to positives, and these two negatives cancel to positives. Because we have an even number, all of our negatives become positives in a way. And so we have 2 times 2 times 2 times 2, which is positive 16. Those are two different things, and I will say that that is something people have a lot of trouble with, so we want to keep reviewing that, and we will in the next video when we do order of operations.